On today, that seventh day of Srimad Devi Bhagavatam. In Devi Bhagavatam, on the seventh day, we call it as Hayagriva, who is nothing but the form of Vishnu. And this Hayagriva has, this Vishnu has there with the body, with legs and everything, but he also has a horse head. Hayavadana. Or, so from Hayavadana, he has Vishnu as in this, in the form of a horse head. So this Vishnu with a horse head is what on the day of today we have Hayavadana Rupa. And what is this Hayavadana Rupa? What does Hayavadana do? What does he do? This is what you should understand. What does this Hayavadana do? What is the role of Vishnu as Hayavadana on this world where all of us exist? What we call it as the Milky Way. Let us take it scientifically as the Milky Way. We also have religiously as the seven worlds, the lower worlds and the higher worlds. So at the same time, Devi said, there is also, Hayavadana has been sent, Vishnu has been sent with a horse head to completely vanquish an asura called as Hayavadana himself. So today I have sent Vishnu with a horse head to remove that daitya or to remove that asura, and that asura is also called as Hayagriva. This is the whole point of how Devi manifested himself with the energy and passed it on and gave Vishnu the name of Hayagriva. And this today it is called as Hayagriva Vadana. This is the whole beauty of that. So the second point, you're right. We understand Hayagriva Avatara, God in the form of Vishnu, along with all the retinue of different avatars of gods, they all assembled in the land of Vaikuntha, because Vaikuntha is the land of consciousness. Chaitanya the Bhumi. So gods came to the earth as avatars in different ways in the form of human beings. So when you see avatars or embodiment of divinity in human form, this is one thing you should understand. More so in Kali Yuga, you will find the embodiment of divinity in human form. So the whole of this earth today in this Kali Yuga is nothing but, if you do sadhana, you will start understanding that this is the land of miracles, because our life here is Vaikuntha, the abode of divine miracles. This is the whole point. What is Vaikuntha? It is the abode of divine miracles. That is why in Kali Yuga, if you do sadhana, then sadhana is fantastic. For example, if you can chant one mala 108 times of mantra japa, one mala is one japa of 108 times. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namo Shivaya. Like this 108 times, what happens? You can invite divine miracles inside your home. Your home and our home and all the earthly beings as nothing but Vaikuntha, the abode of divine miracles. Today, we are now in the land of Vaikuntha. This is most important thing for you to understand. We may be on earth, but particularly on this day, you are in Vaikuntha. So imagine, other than Dasara or other than Navaratri, even then, if you have this bhavana that you are in Vaikuntha, even in whatever day, whatever time it is, you will be able to see miracles. And you will be also able to witness miracles. So when you see and witness divine miracles, you will understand you are in Vaikuntha. So our life is in Vaikuntha, each one of our homes. It is a place of Vaikuntha. So today we establish that fact, our life is in Vaikuntha. So when we go back home, we are coming from Vaikuntha. When we go back home, it is going to be Vaikuntha. When you are here now, it is Vaikuntha. And that Vaikuntha is the abode of divine miracles. You can perform miracles. Why is it so? Because you are nothing but a divine conscious energy where you are filled with consciousness. Each one of you is filled with Chaitanya. So what is Vaikuntha? Each one of us, right from today and for every day from today, you are in Vaikuntha. So have that kind of a God, that kind of a godly feeling. Not only during Navaratri, not only during anything else. If you can think, not think, you can perform. If you think you are eating, that means you are eating Vishnu's prasada. When you are breathing, if you think, I am breathing because of Shiva's air, that means you are breathing Vaikuntha's air. On that moment when you breathe, when you have that feeling you are breathing Vaikuntha's air, not only Kailasa. Because Adi Parashakti very clearly says Mahakali, Mahalakshmi and Mahasaraswati. So when all the three combine together, we call it as Adi Parashakti or Parashakti. This is the whole point in making you understand. Remember, we are in Vaikuntha. And in this Vaikuntha, today we will explain Hayagriva Avatara, a part of Vishnu as Hayagriva. Because Adi Parashakti has conceived, Brahma has conceived Vishnu, and Adi Parashakti has also conceived Ishvara or Parameshvara, Parashiva. And that is Avatara, and Hayagriva is more particularly because Hayagriva is the embodiment of consciousness. And Mother on this day particularly propitiated Vishnu and told him to perform the whole creation and to maintain the creation as Hayagriva, because there is a reason behind Hayagriva. And what is Hayagriva? Vishnu comes with the whole of the system. Only thing is, with Hayagriva, he has a horse head. Avanige kudreina kattina mele kattirotakkantu kudre akara. Why is Vishnu as Hayagriva? Because in Hayagriva avatara, gods came to earth, because everybody, wherever Vishnu is there as Chaitanya, and Vishnu's role is to be the form of Chaitanya, then all the other gods came in human form itself. So what do we get the essence out of this? That is why in Kali Yuga and in all other yugas, what happens is our life becomes Vaikuntha, because divinity is in the human form. So two lessons we learn. Lord Vishnu comes as Hayagriva avatara, and all the gods come in that human form itself. Ida irotakanta vichara. This is the whole point. This is what has been told to us in the Shastras. So divinity comes in the human form. That is why we see lot of avatara purushas. Today we see divinity in the form of avatara purushas. They look like humans, but they are nothing but the embodiment of an avatara. So the God's consciousness comes and settles and crystallizes in this avatara, and more so as Hayagriva. The consciousness comes in, the Chaitanya comes in as Hayagriva, because these gods don't come by themselves. Gods come in different avataras, but the most important avatara in this Kali Yuga is that divinity is in human form only. So what is predominant in them is the Chaitanya. That is why our life in Vaikuntha, and our life is also in Vaikuntha, and that is abode of the divine miracle. So when each of us, that is why we see many miracles being formed here. Nothing is out of the world. Everything is within us, and we see everything in this world. If you look at science, and there are instances where we see, you know, there are certain places in this world where gravity does not work like us here. Gravity doesn't work. You can see there are certain places as far as US where gravity doesn't happen at all. Have you seen an granite ball going above, going as high across the road in an upward plane? There are certain places in this world where they defy gravity. Even if we had a huge ton of weight of a granite ball, it rolls up the slope. As you know, because of gravity, it has to roll downhill. But this granite ball just goes up the slope. It defies gravity. That is why, with so much of authority, our scriptures have said there are certain places in the whole of world where everything defies gravity. That is why our life is Vaikuntha. On this earth, everything is Vaikuntha, the abode of divine miracles.
For more satsangs from Sri Sri Nimishananda Guruji, subscribe to this channel. Click the bell button below to get notifications. Like and share the video and spread the divine message.